I got, like I said, I had a lot of surprises. I got a lot of mixed reviews from people thinking, what?
He's an idiot.
Why would he do that? And a lot of people, just a whole lot of different opinions from people about what I should be doing with my life. And I feel like I was very much a people pleaser. And I try to make everybody happy. But when your lawyer is asking for one thing, your record label's asking for another, your management is asking for another thing, manager, and your product manager is asking for another thing, and then your fans are asking for another thing, and then your family and friends are another, you realize that you can't, when they're all asking for completely different things, you can't make everybody happy. And you start getting this push and pull, tug everywhere, and you start losing a sense of who you are. You start losing your identity because you're that's where I was. I started losing myself, and I just started feeling very unhappy. And I feel like that was one of the biggest signs of going on a mission for my church, the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. And I'd always wanted to go. That's something I always planned on doing. It was the whole thing of being in the season finale of a TV show, American Idol. I wasn't planning on that. And so life took a different turn, but I still felt like I wanted to do this and go on a mission. And despite having the fear of not knowing what was going to happen, change sometimes is really hard for me. And a mission was a big change. I didn't know if it's like, okay, I'd worked for the last several years to be doing this. And if I go, a lot of people said that, well, if you leave, then good luck. You're not going to come back to anything. Everything that you worked for is going to fall apart. You need that momentum. You need to keep going. You need to keep interacting with people, or else they'll forget you. And that's one of the hardest things for me to think of, being forgotten. Not necessarily by millions of people, but just by people, just to know that, I don't know, friends and people, I don't know. So going on a mission was hard. I was like, do I do this or no? And when I decided to go forward and say, okay, I felt like there's this simple feeling, this simple small voice that you can feel and hear inside that I've always trusted, that I've always let me, that I always followed. And it was the same still small voice that told me, you know what, go and audition for this reality show, American Idol. It was the same show, the same voice that told me to stay true to yourself and sing songs that had a meaning and a message to you. And it was the same voice now telling me to go and on this mission. And I felt like this time, change is always hard. And it was the same thing coming back from my mission. It was a hard change. But whether you are moving to a new home, changing schools, going off to university, or even starting to date someone new or asking someone to marry you, change is always going to be a hard thing. And it's going to be a scary thing because you don't know what's going to happen next. And sometimes, to be honest, sometimes I felt like, you know, I don't think I can do this. And I give it up. But that still small voice comes back and it says, keep going. There's more for you than you realize. There's more ahead of you than you think. So this next song, I'd like to dedicate to that. And I'd actually like to invite back one of the Firefly girls, Maddie, to come out and sing this song with me. So please welcome back, Maddie.
Settle down for every job, so many.